Hey YouTube, Dutch Sense here. It is June 15th, 2011, and we are here in Missoula, Montana. The river here, about 30 feet up, in a field, kind of near hotels and stuff, but good spot to get off, get a reading. So here we go. Wait a second. There we go. Again, location, Missoula, Montana. Thank you. Okay, we're almost halfway through the test and we're at about 250, which means we'll probably hit about 500. It's to be expected. We're at a higher altitude here, by about maybe 15 to 2,000 feet higher than where we were just in Washington. So we shall see. And there may be rock down below all this, since we're right on the river's edge. That wouldn't be too big of a surprise. So you can count, I'm going to take multiple counts across Montana, South Dakota, Nebraska, the grain belt where the jet stream dipped. Basically, it came up over Seattle, made a what looks like an N shape up over the mountains, and then came back down over the plains. So North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Kansas, Iowa, and Missouri. And that is the next stop, is here in Montana, then North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Iowa, and then back home. And what I'm going to do for California, guys, is I'm going to come back out. I've got airfare connection, so somebody's going to hook me up with airfare, and I'm going to fly out to California, Southern Cal, and get some measurements there in the next week or so. So, and that'll just be a day trip. I go out for the day and come back that night. Just go up, get some measurements, see what it's like. And maybe Central Cal up to Northern Cal. We'll see. I'll probably fly into San Fran. We did the math, and we can't afford to drive all the way down California, stop several times, add several days on, and then we would have to drive through the southern states, which I'm not too concerned about, which basically they did not receive the jet stream flow that the northern states did over the winter when Fukushima, over the spring, I should say, when Fukushima happened. And we are almost a little bit under 8 minutes. About 350. That's right on what's to be expected. And what I think happened is Fukushima melted down, but the amount that they're telling us is just, it's not accurate. We should be seeing levels in the thousands for cesium everywhere over here. And we're not. Instead, we're seeing about a 10 to 20 count per minute hike across the board everywhere. So, you know, if St. Louis was 200 counts per minute, it's now 300 counts per minute. If the mountains were 600 and 700 counts per minute, now they're 800 and 900 counts per minute. If the West Coast, Washington, was 1 to 200 counts per minute, now it's 2 to 300, maybe even 400 counts per minute. So the amounts did go up, but it's a scam and a lie what we've been told, which is that it's, you know, extinction level event, 60 years worth or 60,000 tons worth of stored rods, etc. Well, that's just, if that happened, then there should be high levels. Okay, just under 9 minutes, and we're at about 500. That's about right. And considering we are in the Rocky Mountains, literally, that is to be expected. Okay, guys, we're nearing the end of the count. And it looks like we are going to just break 500. There you go. 53.4, or 534 over 10 minutes averaged out. It's 53.4 per minute. And that is about what's to be expected up here in the mountains. So there you go, guys. We are here in Missoula, Montana, right off the river, and it's right up. I mean, it's huge. The river is swelled and at its banks, at the tip of its banks. So we're here in a field, Missoula, Montana, kind of there, off to their south of their downtown area. All right, folks, much love. Hang in there. Cheers.